What if you or someone you loved was born with an inherited disorder, and you were told it could be cured by a relatively simple treatment that included genetically correcting your DNA? Would you do it? Hey Genies, it's Trace here for DNews. With new gene editing technology emerging from Carnegie Mellon and Yale universities, genetic engineering may be up in us sooner than you think. Researchers at Carnegie Mellon's Center for Nucleic Acid Science and Technology, say that 10 times fast, have developed a way to treat inherited blood disorders using synthetic molecules called peptide nucleic acid molecules, or PNA. PNA is a biomolecular structure created by researchers that can mimic DNA as it's structured similarly. Think of PNA as a blank document that scientists can just add genetic code to. PNA can be designed to bind to specific parts of gene sequences, which allow scientists to fix a malfunctioning piece of DNA that is the cause of a disease. In this particular case, they are fixing the gene that's responsible for a blood disorder. So, in this new study, scientists coded the PNA to target haematopoietic stem cells that make other blood cells. They then injected that into a living organism. The PNA slipped into the cells, found the site of the problem, then bound itself to the malfunctioning DNA to form a PNA-DNA-PNA triplex chain, mending it by correcting the sequence. Try saying that 10 times fast. Right now, this technique is used to treat inherited blood disorders. According to the World Health Organization, nearly 5% of the world is born with inherited hemoglobin disorders like sickle cell anemia and beta thalassemia. Beta thalassemia disrupts the creation of hemoglobin and causes extreme anemia, stunted growth and enlarged organs, among other ailments. Until now, there's been no real cure for beta thalassemia, but this new gene editing technique may be the answer. In mice, researchers have seen a 7% success rate in curing beta thalassemia. This might sound low, but other gene editing treatments have only been 0.1% successful. Also, in a disorder like beta thalassemia, a 100% cure isn't necessary to regain improved health. Even if the person isn't cured, they may be able to produce more hemoglobin to help alleviate their condition. The FDA has approved this synthetic nucleotide technology after testing it on mouse and human bone marrow. The technique has advantages over the other gene editing treatment you may have heard of, CRISPR-Cas9, in two ways. First, CRISPR cannot simply be injected into the body like the new PNA gene correcting process. With CRISPR, cells have to be removed to receive the treatment in the lab, then they're injected back into the body. Second, with CRISPR, it's not perfect. Once the cells are in the body, there's a chance that the enzymes could indiscriminately cut DNA in the wrong place, thus rendering the treatment useless, and it could be potentially harmful. This won't happen in this new treatment. The technology has excited scientists as it can possibly lead to developments in curing other genetically inherited blood disorders like sickle cell diseases that affect 100,000 Americans, and hopefully other diseases too in the not-so-distant future. If you're interested in learning about diseases, maybe you'd like the Animal Planet show Monsters Inside Me. It has great computer animation. And now you can watch that and other Animal Planet shows on the Animal Planet Go app. Download for free at your app store or check out the link below. If you'd like to know more about CRISPR and how that also has huge promise, check out this episode. What do you think? Would you be willing to try this new gene editing technique and fix an inherited disorder? Tell us in the comments below, then subscribe to get more DNews every day.